Hello, this is Konstantinos Papadopoulos. I'm a cardiologist at the European Rebaka Medical Center in Thessaloniki, Greece. And in this tutorial, we're going to talk about the new PASCAL system of Edwards. It is the Transcatheter mitral valve leaflet repair system. These are my disclosures. As you all know, mitral valve has a complex anatomy. It consists of two asymmetric leaflets, one large anterior and one smaller posterior leaflet. We have the subvalvular apparatus with papillary muscles and cordae. And from the patients suffering from valvular heart diseases, 25% of them have mitral regurgitation. And it is important to know the classification, the Carpentier classification, and to differentiate the primary from secondary MR. When we talk about secondary MR, we know that we have a diseased left ventricle and tethering of the leaflets towards the apex. And it is not an actual pathology of the mitral valve. Unfortunately, from the patients suffering from mitral regurgitation, half of them are considered inoperable. And the reasons for that are of the older age, the comorbidities, and the low ejection fraction. And by 2040, we know that MR incidence will more than double, and the need for solutions for these inoperable patients is great. But mitral valve is a challenging valve. It's not aortic. It is a dynamic valve, larger. It's proximal to the LVOT, and it changes size and shape during systole. But however, there are many transcatheter devices that target either to the leaflet repair, like a mitral clip and PASCAL, or to the annulus with annuloplasty, like Carillon and Cardioband. And of course, we have valves for direct implantation at the mitral valve, replacement of the mitral valve. In this presentation, we're going to talk about PASCAL. It looks like the mitral clip, but it is different. We will see the features in the next slides. Here you can see that this device has two paddles and two clasps, and the concept is to grasp the leaflets between the clasp and the paddle. And we also have a spacer that it is in between the paddles, and this spacer fulfills the regurgitant orifice area. One important feature of this device is that we can independently capture the anterior or the posterior leaflet, and this is important in cases where we have mitral valve prolapse and we want to grasp the prolapsed and mobile leaflet first and then grasp with the opposite leaflet. Of course, this device is bigger than the mitral clip, and we have the spacer between the paddles. And these two are the reasons why, with fewer implants, we can achieve the best result. And that's why most of our patients were finished the operation with just one PASCAL, while at the same time, these patients would need at least two clips. This device is safer than mitral clip because when it is attached to the cordae at the subvalvular apparatus, we can elongate it and retract back to the left atrium without causing any damage to the cordae. And as you can see this animation video, this device comes elongated into the left atrium, and then we retract back the paddles in order to gain some space into the left atrium. We turn the device to the mitral valve. We check the perpendicularity because we want to go perpendicular into the left ventricle. And then we go into the left ventricle, we retract back, and we make sure that the leaflets are on the paddles. And if we don't like the grasping, then we can regrasp independently the leaflets. We have to mention that this device goes from the femoral vein in the inferior vena cava, the right atrium. We do a transseptal puncture, and then the delivery system goes into the left atrium. These steps are exactly the same with mitral clip. And for users and people that have experience in mitral clip, it is very important to know these steps, and the images are familiar, and this makes the technique easier for someone that has experience from mitral clip implantation to move from the mitral clip to the PASCAL. The first publication was in Lancet with 23 compassionate use patients, either DMR or fMR. And we saw that this device is effective in reducing mitral regurgitation. And of course, we have improvement, clinical improvement in terms of mitral class status. The study for CE mark of the device was the CLASP study. And fortunately, in London Valves last year, we had the first, the 1 year results of this study, where we saw that the device is effective in reducing mitral regurgitation, and almost all patients had clinical improvement with NIHA class status. And after these results and the CLASP study, the device took a CE mark approval, and it is used for commercial use in Europe, but not in the United States. For echocardiographers, it is important to know these steps for guidance for implantation. And as you can see, most of them are exactly the same with mitral clip. And this makes the operation easier for us that have experience with other transcatheter devices. Before going to implantation, it is important to have a correct diagnosis, and we have to use all the available measures, either transthoracic or transesophageal echo. We have to measure the ERO. We have to check the color Doppler. You see here that we have regurgitation coming from the whole coaptation line of the valve. We have to check the 3D and fast views. Here we have two different patients, one at the left with functional mitral regurgitation, where you can see that we don't have any pathology of the leaflets. And at the right side, we have a patient with prolapse of the P2 part of the posterior leaflet towards the lateral part of the leaflet. And it is important to show the interventionist this image, these images, as he will understand where he has to implant the PASCAL. Of course, we can use other techniques like MVQ analysis to demonstrate the prolapse, for example, or vena contracta area to measure exactly the regurgitan orifice area by 3D. And then when we have the correct diagnosis of the mitral regurgitation, we proceed with the procedure. First of all, we have to do a correct and nice transseptal puncture, because if the puncture is correct, then this will make the whole operation very easy. We have to use biplane views of a short axis view of the septum and the bicaval view. We have to demonstrate the aorta for the anterior part and the posterior part of the septum. And of course, we have to check the superior and the inferior part of the septum from the bicaval view. 3D imaging can facilitate the operation. And when we check the right side of the septum, this is the right side of the septum, we place the aorta at the right side of the image here, and we know that we have the superior vena cava, the inferior vena cava, the fossa ovalis, and here you can see the SLO catheter coming down, coming lower from the superior vena cava to the fossa ovalis, and we can guide our interventionist. When we are at the thinner part of the septum, at the fossa ovalis, we know that we have to puncture high, so we have to go superior here, and we have to puncture at the middle or going or to posterior part of the septum at the short axis view, because we have to be away from the aorta, not to perforate the aorta. So these two views are important for a nice transseptal puncture. So remember, you have to puncture superior and middle to posterior. Then we have to measure, before puncture, we have to measure the height. You see there we have a tending of the septum, and from this point we measure the height towards the annulus, towards the mitral valve annulus, and we have to be more than 4 centimeters higher from the annulus. And after measuring the height, we proceed with the extra strip wire towards the left atrium. And at this step, it is important to guide the wire towards the pulmonary vein, because we don't want to perforate the left atrial appendage. Over the wire, we advance the guide. Here you can see the delivery system into the left atrium, and with it, with 3D views, we can demonstrate the direction of the guide into the left atrium. And then the next step is to implant, to advance the PASCAL system. The PASCAL comes elongated into the left atrium, as you can see in the left image. And then we retract the paddles back, as you see in this right image. And this move is important to gain some space and not touch the free wall of the left atrium or the Coumadin ridge when we turn to the mitral valve. This is the fluoroscopic view of the PASCAL system. This is the delivery system from the inferior vena cava to the right atrium. We've done the puncture, and then we implant the device into the left atrium with the paddles back. Afterwards, we turn the PASCAL system to the mitral valve. We must be careful not to touch the Coumadin ridge, and we have to use these biplane views, a commissural view and a long axis view, in order to guide our interventionist towards lateral, medial, anterior, and posterior. You have to remember that the lateral part of the mitral valve is the part where we have the left atrial appendage. And this is important, this view is very important for the interventionist, and we have to know how to demonstrate the valve from all the sides. This is the fluoroscopic view with the delivery system towards the mitral valve. Then the next step is to check the perpendicularity. At the left image, you can see a PASCAL device with the paddles open, and this is wrong. We must not go into the left ventricle with this direction. We have to turn counterclockwise the paddles in order to go perpendicular to the coaptation line. And this is important in order not to distort the valve after grasping, and in order to grasp the most of the leaflets that we can. Then we go below the mitral valve into the left ventricle, and we retract back and to make sure that the leaflets are on the paddles, as you can see at this left image. And when the leaflets are on the paddles, we lower the clasps. And in this image, it is important to see with this biplane, you can see that the leaflets are on the paddles. We have lowered the clasps, and you can see a bouncing of the clasps, which means that the leaflets are enough into the paddles. And then we are sure that we have done a nice grasping with more than 7 millimeters of leaflet into each paddle. It is important to measure the leaflet, the part of the leaflet that we have into the paddle, and the minimum is 7 millimeters for each leaflet. So if we see this bouncing of the clasps, we are sure that we have a nice result. If we don't see, it's okay. But after the grasping, here you can see the time that the paddles are closing, and we are doing the grasping of the anterior and the posterior leaflet. But after that, we have to do the leaflet insertion. We have to scan at this commissural view the valve from the right and the left side of the paddles to check if we have a nice grasping. We can go with the transgastric view and see if both leaflets are into the paddles. And then with fluoroscopic view, we have here we have the paddles open, and here we have the paddles closed, and it is the time that we release the device. The device can be released after we've done the leaflet insertion and we are sure that we have enough leaflets into the paddles, and we can demonstrate it both with fluoroscopic views and 2D and 3D views. This is the fluoroscopic view with the paddle. At this view, we see that we have a stable device. If we have a single leaflet detachment, then you will see a funny movement of the device. You will see that it's going freely. And it is not that stable like in this image. And then finally, we check the bridging between the anterior and posterior leaflet. Here you see a double orifice mitral valve with a nice bridging between the anterior and posterior leaflet, and a very nice result with mild regurgitation. Of course, before releasing the device, it is important to measure the mean gradient of the valve, because if the mean gradient is above 4 or 5, then we that means that we have produced iatrogenic mitral valve stenosis, and we have to take back the PASCAL implant and not finish the operation. And here you can see a huge, severe mitral regurgitation managed with just one PASCAL device in a patient. So in summary, as you can see, our early experience with PASCAL system proved that this device is safe and efficient in reducing mitral regurgitation. For echocardiographers that have experience with mitral clip, it's easier to implant a PASCAL because almost all steps are the same. And this device has approval for commercial use in Europe, but not in the United States. And it is important in centers that have a heart team to have a strong imaging team in order to have a correct diagnosis of mitral regurgitation patients and be able to guide the implantation of these devices. Thank you very much.